welcome, Sagittarius. I'm Brenda, Brenda Tarot, and I'm here again today to bring you your Angel Tarot and your Oracle reading for the week of July the 15th to the 22nd. I want to thank you for your interest in my channel and for viewing, liking, sharing, but most of all, subscribing to them. Please be sure to click the bell button next to subscribe and you'll get notified immediately when these go out on open air for you to view on YouTube. As you know, this is strictly a general reading. Every single card will not resonate with every single Sagittarius out there, but if it does, run with it and throw the rest out into the universe that doesn't resonate. But if you'd like clarity, accuracy, and answers to any questions, then I invite you to click that little icon in the top right-hand corner of this video and it will whisk you right over into my website where you can see the services that I offer. All the other information is posted below. Okay, my beautiful Sagittarius, let's see what we have here for the week of July the 15th. Your all-over energy tells me you're moving on. You got the release card in the Angel Tarot, and it is the death card in the traditional tarot. I'm using the Hanson and Roberts traditional tarot deck today. So this is telling me that you're going to be able to move on. This is the end of a phase or a situation in your life, Sagittarius, that has come into play, and now you're moving in a new direction. This is about you not looking over your shoulder and dragging the past into your present so that it influences your future. You are walking away. You are leaving what happened in the past behind you. You've learned the lessons, and now you realize it's time to move on in a new direction. It's almost transformation for you. It's like spiritual transformation for you. You may be realizing that you're going to be doing things differently. You may be walking your path to become the person that maybe in the past you were restricted from being, and who you wanted to become, the things you wanted to do, and your passion, and your desires, and your goals. Now you're walking in a new direction, looking forward to that, pushing yourself into that, leaning into your abundance and filling those cups. So it's time to move on. That's what this card signifies. This is a perfect time, and it was meant to be. It was divinely sent. It was karmically sent. It was universally sent at this time. It was meant to happen on your path, and now you're going to move in a new direction. Leave that past behind you, Sagittarius. We can't change what happened then. All you can look forward to is a positive new beginning in a new direction, because you're going to get it. This is unbelievable. You've got the wheel. This is a beautiful, beautiful card. And it's telling me, it's like the Wheel of Fortune. It's telling me that, you know what? This is completion. Just like the release said, leaving the past behind and moving forward. This is completion. This is fulfillment. This is full circle. This is a time of positive change. You are moving in that direction, Sagittarius. You're going to be able to propel and have the momentum to go forward. We don't go in reverse, we go forward. And it suddenly moves you forward, a situation that has made you go in this direction. And it's as though it was meant to be. It's like fortune's on your side now. You're being protected, you're being guided. Okay? This is Archangel Michael on this wheel. All right? You are being protected and it was meant to be. So stand in your confidence, stand in your power, Sagittarius. Don't be afraid of change. Don't look over your shoulder. It's done. You're moving on, my friend, in a beautiful, beautiful new positive direction for positive change. And it's for the better. Fortune's on your side. Wow, beautiful card. You've got the Four of Water coming along during the week. The Four of Cups. You know what? And this shows me that, you know, some of you may have been in a situation or a relationship where you felt things didn't work out the way they should have, and you felt like you were missing an opportunity. But there's new possibilities here. Do not look at what you lost, but look at what you have yet to gain and fill. This is a whole new direction you're going. You've got the Wheel of Fortune. You're putting the past behind you. And yeah, you felt like you were missing an opportunity, so now you've stepped up, Sagittarius, and you're making that work to your benefit. You know what? You're moving forward in a better direction, and you've got cups yet, Sagittarius, to fill. Keep your eyes open for any new possibilities coming down your path, any offers being presented to you. Perhaps they may be offers of love. These are the cups, things on an emotional level. You've got the Nine of Earth, so we talk about an emotional emotional fulfillment. Now you've got a material fulfillment, the nine of earth. This is all about looking at things with vision now and seeing your future unfold before you. You've learned now that you can't make promises you can't fulfill. So you're doing things the way you know you want to do them. You're going to be able to walk in your garden of abundance again. You're getting the fulfillment here, moving forward in a new direction. You've left these sad times behind. You've released that. The past is gone. Okay, you're moving forward. You've got the Wheel of Fortune here propelling you in a positive new future and direction. And the nine of earth says make a wish. You're going to be able to see all of this abundance coming into you. You're going to be able to enjoy life's luxuries again. I see that you're sitting there, you're contemplating, you're thinking, you're processing, you know, all that has come to pass and where you are now. Some of you may be thinking about stepping out and wanting to become your own entrepreneur. Some of you may be wanting to be your own boss. You may be wanting your own business. You may be wanting to be self-employed and in charge and command of your own destiny. This is moving forward. Perhaps you've stepped out and you've left the past behind, a job behind, and you've said, I want to be my own boss. I'm going to set up my own business. You're going to see the success in that. The Wheel of Fortune came out. And yes, you're going to see that things might not have worked out in your favor in the past, and that's what's made you go in this new direction. This will be successful self-employment for some of you. Great energy happening this week, so you're going to be able to walk in your garden of prosperity and see your harvest come in. You've dealt with the losses in the past, and now you're moving forward because you want to improve this situation and fill your cups again with prosperity and abundance. The Wheel of Fortune is telling us that you're going to have it, and you're leaving the past behind because you realized it wasn't giving you what you wanted in your fulfillment and in your prosperity and in your happiness, and you're making it happen here. Well, is that not confirmation? Sagittarius, there's the sun. You're illuminating your path now. You're seeing your vision. You're stepping up. You're seeing your future unfold. You're looking at it with vision. You're driving yourself in that direction. And you've completed a section on your path. Full circles happen, and now you're moving forward. You're illuminating your own path. You're your own brilliant beacon of light here. Wonderful. You're going to be given options and choices. Doors are opening for you now. This is amazing, Sagittarius. Some of you, it will have to do with your employment. Excuse me while I have a drink of water here. I'm losing my voice. You're going to have doors being opened for you, Sagittarius, and you will have options coming in. How many people get options and offers? More than one. You're going to have at least two, and you will sit down, process it, and pick the right one. Slow and steady, though. Don't jump into the quicksand, okay? This is telling me that you need to push forward, but slow and steady. This is about being realistic, being practical and self-reliant. And you, in anything that hasn't worked out for you in the past, you're going to turn that situation to your advantage. You're going to get to the top here. You're going to make that. You're going to get where it is you want to go, Sagittarius. So stay focused. Don't worry about how long it's taking you. Beautiful. Okay, let's see what we have here for our beautiful Wisdom of the Oracle deck. This is a new deck I'm using today. I'm telling all of you, and I love it, and I want your feedback. And this is by the book. So let's see what they're saying to you by the book. This is about abiding by social rules, conformity, respecting culture and family customs and universal laws. The universe works within a structure of divine laws and principles that provides a framework for human experience and evolution. The law of abundance, the law of prayer, the law of karma, the law of attraction, the law of thought, the law of compensation, and the law of nature are only a few that are known. These principles create perfect order and operate with a kind of precision beyond human understanding. Even revolution has its place in universal law. Human beings, in turn, have their own laws and customs that vary from culture to culture and family to family. Laws keep social order and govern behavior, reflecting an instinctive understanding that harmony is important. This is a time to learn these laws and conform to them, rather than being the rebel and flouting them. When this card appears, submit to structure and follow the rules, even if they seem to make no sense. Release resistance, for universal laws will correct any disharmony. Open your eyes, Sagittarius, to those universal laws, and it will be easier to go by the book at this time. So if this has to do with a relationship, going by the book, you know, it's all about getting along with others. And that entails understanding and respecting who they have become as a result of their environment, culture, and experience. Find the middle ground that allows you in this relationship to flourish while honoring the individuality of the other person. Play things by the book instead of trying to break the rules or pressure others to conform to the way you want to do them. Your connection will deepen as a result. So let's see by the book what it means to for the prosperity message. At this time, you can expect a return on your investment. Whatever you have pursued, be it a dream you've long cherished, a skill you've cultivated, or a service you've called to, will come to you if you are willing to go by the book. You don't need to reinvent the wheel to be successful. Follow in the footsteps of others who have already achieved the things you're striving for. You can learn a lot by observing the structures that are already working. Your creative projects and commitment of prosperity are in alignment with the needs of the world, but impatience may tempt you to cut corners to get there more quickly. Stick with what you know works, and you will attract the abundance you want. Beautiful message, beautiful message. I love these cards. They're so explicit, they're so direct. When it comes to a relationship, when it comes to the general meeting, when it comes to the prosperity we want in our lives, and you're making these changes now, okay? You're allowing the wheel to propel in a forward direction without resisting. You're not putting the brakes on here. You're moving forward. And you've had time, because I said things were taking time here, slow and steady, but you're starting to see the light. Meditation. Your soul is yearning to communicate with you, so sit quietly and listen. You're processing all of this that's going on. Let the light of your soul fill your heart and mind. Listen to the guidance that comes from within. Pay attention to your inner world and don't be distracted by what is going on outside of you. All you need is inside you and not outside of you. The outer world is full of distractions and illusions. In your inner world resides your truth. If you are struggling to find an answer or a solution to something, then still your mind through meditation and soon all will become clear. Close your eyes. Press your fingertips together. Breathe slowly and watch your thoughts come and go like clouds drifting across the sky. Step back from your mind and observe its patterns and repetitions. Who is the driver here anyway? Who is the watcher? Breathe. Beautiful, beautiful card of meditation. Take yourself to the silence. Think about where it is you want to go and what you want to do. And often we receive the answers to our biggest questions when we take ourselves to the silence. And we talk to ourselves. And we talk to our inner healing. And we talk to our inner strength and our inner power. And our inner faith. Do things by the book, my friend. Don't push things. Don't force things. Go with the motion of the wheel moving you forward, and this is a positive direction. You've walked away from the past. You're leaving it behind you and to go in this new direction. You're going to see your cups fill again, and you're going to be able to walk in your garden of prosperity and see the abundance coming into you that you've worked hard. You are lighting your own. You're illuminating your own path now, being able to see light at the end of the path. Doors are opening for you. Illuminating your path, you're seeing doors open for you. Stay positive. You'll have choices here to make it and go through the right door and pick the right option and opportunity. It may take a little time, but stay focused. Slow and steady wins the race. Well, my beautiful Sagittarius, this is your reading for the week of July the 15th. And I wish you a great positive week here to look forward to. And I also want you to remember the universe and the divine, your higher power, wants you to succeed and find your happiness and peace. So surrender to it, Sagittarius. Move forward towards your goals and your happiness. Much love and light. Blessings, my beautiful souls, and know that I'll see you soon, and I always and only stand in this circle of love and light for you.